Hello students, welcome back. I am Rinkesh Rao and today we are going to start standard 11th NCERT textual exercise of chapter number 4, that is motion in a plane. Okay, so let's start with the exercise. 4.1. State for each of the following physical quantities if it is a scalar or a vector. Okay, that means you have to differentiate the scalar quantities and vector quantities. First, let's select the vector quantities. Vectors means which requires direction. Volume doesn't require direction. Mass, speed doesn't require direction. Acceleration requires direction. Okay, so this is a vector quantity. Density doesn't require direction. Number of mole doesn't require. Velocity requires direction. So velocity is a vector quantity. Angular frequency doesn't require direction. Displacement requires direction. And angular velocity, that also requires direction. So acceleration, velocity, displacement and angular velocity, these are the vector quantities. And volume, mass, speed, density, number of moles, angular frequency, these are the scalar quantities. Clear? Now let's see 4.2. Pick out the two scalar quantities in the following list. Okay, means you have to pick out the scalar quantities which does not require direction. Okay. So force, okay, that is a vector quantity. Angular momentum, vector quantity. Work is a scalar quantity. Okay, so work, that is equal to force into displacement. Force and displacement both are vector, but it is the scalar product. So work is a scalar quantity. Current is a scalar quantity, right? Electric current. That does not require direction. Linear momentum vector, electric field vector, average velocity vector, magnetic moment vector and relative velocity vector. Okay, so work and current, these are the two scalar quantities. Now let's see 4.3. Pick out the only vector quantity in the following list. Okay, means you have to find out the only vector quantity. Temperature, scalar, pressure, scalar, impulse is a vector quantity. Okay, time, power, total path length, energy, gravitational potential, coefficient of friction, charge, everything are scalar. So impulse is a vector quantity. Impulse means force into time. F dash dot t, that is impulse of force. Okay, as force is a scalar vector quantity, when you multiply a vector with a scalar, the answer will be vector. So impulse is a vector quantity. Okay, so this was about 4.1, 4.2 and 4.3. Now let's move to 4.4. State with reasons whether the following algebraic operations with scalar and vector physical quantities are meaningful or not. The first is adding any two scalar quantities. Okay, then I will say this as no. Okay, actually it's not every time that it would be meaningful. Addition of two scalar is only possible if their dimension are same, because only possible if their dimensions are same. Okay, means you can add two quantities which are scalar, like 5 kg plus 6 kg, but you cannot add 5 kg plus 3 meter, right? Because both are having different dimensional formula. So you can only add any two scalar quantities if their dimension are same. Otherwise, it will be meaningless. B, adding a scalar to a vector of the same dimensions? No, this is never possible. You cannot add a scalar to a vector. Remember, you cannot add a scalar quantity to a vector quantity, whether it is the same dimension or different, right? So no, this is not meaningful. C, multiplying any vector by any scalar, yes, it is possible. Okay, see, yes, it is possible, right? Because you can multiply any vector by a scalar. Example, momentum. Momentum is equal to mass into velocity. Mass is scalar and velocity is vector. Another example, force. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. Again, mass here is scalar and acceleration is vector. Okay, so when you multiply any vector with a scalar, the magnitude of vector is multiplied by the magnitude of scalar. Means if the value of vector is 5, then when you are multiplying by any scalar, then it becomes scalar times. Okay, means when it is done, the magnitude of vector increases. I mean to say that the magnitude of vector increases by the value of scalar quantity. Clear? So this was about C. Yes, this is possible. D, multiplying any two scalar, of course this is possible, right? Definitely. D, yes, you can always multiply two scalar. If I take example, then I can take example work is equal to power into time. Use the formula power equal to work done per unit time. So that means work equal to power into time. Power is scalar, time is scalar, right? Another formula, we were using electric current, I equal to Q by T. So I can also use the amount of charge flowing, Q equal to IT, electric current scalar, time scalar, right? So of course, you can multiply two scalar quantities. Next, E, adding any two vectors, no. That is not meaningful because you can only add two vectors again if the dimensions are same, just similar to scalar, right? So you cannot add, okay? Only added vectors can be only added if the dimensions are same. Then only you can add, either it is vector or scalar. You need to add, that means the dimensions of both must be same. Next is F. F is adding a component of a vector to the same vector. Yes, of course it is possible. You can add a component of a vector to the same vector as the dimension would be same, right? Because dimensions will be same. So you can add a component of a vector only to the same vector. Clear? So C, D and F are meaningful and other are not meaningful. Okay, so this was about 4.4. Now let's move to the next one. 4.5, read each of the statement below carefully and state with reason if it is true or false. A, the magnitude of a vector is always a scalar. Yes, it is true, right? See, magnitude does not include direction. So the magnitude of a vector will be always a scalar quantity, right? B, each component of a vector is always a scalar. No, this is false. Okay. See, each component is having direction. If I take I component, this x component, that will be in the x direction of positive x axis. If it is plus I, if it is plus j, that will be in the direction of y axis. Right? If I take any vector e equal to 3i plus 4j, then what does this mean? This component is in the direction of positive x axis. And this in the direction of positive y axis. So each component is having direction. So it is not always a, it is, you cannot say that it is always a scalar. Okay. The total path length is always equal to the magnitude of displacement vector or a particle. No, it is false. See, path length can be equal to displacement vector, magnitude of displacement vector, if it is a straight line. Means if an object is moving in this way, okay, from point A to point B, in this case displacement will be equal to path length. Okay, but the question says here always, if a person moves from A to B and B to C, A to B and B to C. Okay, then AC is the displacement. Here, displacement is equal to AC and path length that will be equal to AB plus AC. So, in this case, the path length is greater than displacement. Right? So, remember, the path length will be always greater than or equal to the magnitude of displacement. Okay, it cannot be always equal. It can be either equal or greater than. And it can be equal only in one case, if it is in a straight line. Clear? D. The average speed of a particle is either greater or equal to the magnitude of average velocity of the same interval of time. Yes, it is true. See, what is speed? Speed is equal to path length upon time. Velocity is equal to displacement upon time. Now, in just the earlier sum, we have studied that path length is always greater than or equal to displacement. Okay, that means both are in numerator. So, speed will be always greater than or equal to velocity. So, the average speed is either greater or equal to the magnitude of average velocity. That is true. Yeah. The last one, E. Three vectors not lying in a plane, they can never add up to give a null vector. Yes, it is true. See, if they are not in a plane, then it cannot form a triangle in the same plane, in the same order. Right? We cannot use the triangular method or parallelogram method to add up. Right? So if they are not lying in a plane, they can never add up to give a null vector. Clear? So A, D and E, these are true. B and C are false. Clear? This was about 4.5. Now let's move to the next one. 4.6. Establish the following vector inequalities geometrically or otherwise. Okay, so you have to establish this equation. So this inequality is geometrically. Okay? Here A plus B, see A is written in bold, that means it is vector A, and B also, clear? So we will represent it by vector symbol. Let's take vector A, let's take this as vector A, okay, and this as vector B. Okay, I have taken two vectors. That is this first as vector A and vector B. Okay, Now let's use the triangular method. Let's use the triangular method to add these two vectors. So what I will do first, I will draw vector A. Okay, and from the tip of A, from the head of A, I will join the tail of vector B. Okay, let's just do vector B. Okay, A and B. So the vector from the tail of the A to head of the B, this will be vector A plus B. Okay, this is vector A. This is vector. Sorry, this is A plus B. Vector A, vector B, and this is. Let's give the name O. P, let OP be vector A, PQ be vector B, and OQ be vector A plus B. Now we know that in a triangle, okay, in a triangle, the any one of the side is less than the sum of the other two sides. Okay, means the value of or the length of any one side is always less than the sum of other two sides. So here I can write it down OQ, that is less than OP plus PQ. Okay, clear? Now see, if in this case, if A and B both were in same direction, like vector A and vector B, in that case it will be A plus B equal to A and B. Means magnitude of A plus B will be equal to magnitude of A plus magnitude of B. Means if I take in this case OPQ, this is A and this is B, then OQ will be equal to OP plus PQ, right? In that case, if this is the case, so if I merge both these cases, then I can write it down OQ will be less than equal to OP plus OQ. Now what is OQ? What is the length of OQ? The magnitude of this vector A plus B. Okay, less than equal to. What is OP? Magnitude of A. And what is PQ? Magnitude of B. Okay, so geometrically I had shown A plus B is less, magnitude of A plus B is less than equal to magnitude of A plus magnitude of B. Okay, now again using the same principle, okay, I must write down that length of one side is always less than sum of other two sides in triangle. So this implies this first case and this both, then I will combine it. Okay, now again I will use the same principle. Length of one side is always less than the sum of length of other two sides. So I can write it down that OP will be always less than equal to OQ plus PQ. Okay, clear? OP, this is the length, that is magnitude of A. It's less than equal to sum of these two sides. So what is OQ? A plus B, so magnitude of A plus B. What is PQ? Magnitude of B. Okay, so when I take B on this side, it will be A minus B is less than equal to A plus B. Or else I can write it down magnitude of A plus B. Sorry, this will plus. Okay, that will be greater than equal to magnitude of A minus magnitude of B. Okay, so this was the first one which I had proved, and this was the second one. Clear? This was about the first and second, where I used the triangular method for addition. Now for C and D, we need to use subtraction. Okay, so before that, just note down this A and B. Okay, now let's see for C and D. Now for A minus D. So I will first draw vector A. Now B is in this direction. So minus B would be in opposite direction, right? This would be vector minus B. So I will draw it here this way. Okay, this is minus B. Okay, so joining the tail of A and the head of minus B, I will get A minus B. Okay, let's say this as OP vector A, PQ vector B, and OQ will be vector A minus B. Clear? So again, we will use the same phenomena that the sum of, the length of any one side is always less than or equal to the sum of other two sides. Okay, so I will take OQ. Clear? OQ will be always less than equal to OP plus PQ. Clear? Equal to, because if both are in same direction. So that is the reason I have used. Now OP, OQ, what is OQ? A minus B. So length, for length I need to take the magnitude A minus B, less than equal to OP. What is vector OP? Okay, sorry, length OP, magnitude of A, plus PQ, that is magnitude of minus B. See, I take minus B or plus B, magnitude doesn't include negative sign. So I will write down magnitude of minus B, because magnitude doesn't include direction, right? So either I write magnitude of minus B or magnitude of plus B, it will have same value, right? So this I had proved the first one, the third one, that is C. A minus B is less than equal to vector A. Sorry, magnitude of vector A minus vector B is less than equal to magnitude of vector A plus magnitude of vector B. Now, again, I will use the same phenomena that the sum of, the length of any one side is always less than equal to the other two sides. Less than the other two sides of a triangle. Okay. So now, here I will take PQ. Okay, PQ is less than, I will write an equal to, if they are in the same direction, OQ plus OP. Okay, PQ is less than the other two sides. What is PQ? Magnitude is magnitude of vector B, less than equal, right? Is plus or minus, both will be same. OQ, what is OQ? Vector A minus B, so its magnitude will be magnitude of A minus B plus. Okay, OP, what is OP? Magnitude of A. So when I take A on this side, it will be magnitude of B minus magnitude of A, that will be less than equal to magnitude of, okay, I just taken the wrong thing. I need to take OP. Okay, because I need to prove it's magnitude of A minus B, not B minus A. Okay. So what I will use, here OP equal to, OP is less than equal to OQ plus PQ. What is OP? Magnitude of vector OQ, that is A minus B, plus PQ, that is vector B. I will use minus or plus, both will be same. When I take B on this side, A minus B, that is less than equal to A minus B, or else vector A minus vector B. That is A minus B, its magnitude is greater than equal to A minus B. Clear? Okay. So this I had proved D1. When I will take both the same magnitude, it will be remaining C. Here, so this was C and D. Just note it down. Okay, students, so that's it for today. In the next video lecture, we will continue from 4.7. Thank you.